sacrificed much to be here. Therefore, the graces I offer my hand. Welcome home. I bid you welcome. I bid you welcome.
Kia ora koutou, nau mai haere mai ki ngā hui nei, hei whakamanawatia ngā ākonga o te tau nei. Kia ora, welcome to this year's Prizegiving for Gore High School, the last of many. If you could stand for the processional and the staff, please. This may be a long stand, we're going to stand until the end of the national anthem. If you need to sit, that doesn't apply to the young folk. If you need to sit, please do. But please stand. Thank you.
singing the National Anthem. Sarah.
Ena mana, ena reo, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa, ngā mihi nui kia koutou. Ladies and gentlemen, our special guests, the mayor and others, parents, grandparents, supporters of our school, staff, and most importantly, the reason we gather here tonight, our outstanding young students. There are apologies tonight from Mr. Brendan Harricks, our board chairperson, or the presiding member, as they now call him, for unexpected family reasons. Mr. Harricks is unable to be here tonight. So usually Mr. Harricks would speak about now and deliver a speech, so this creates the opportunity for me to speak for longer. But I can assure you that's not going to happen. In fact, I intend to make this the shortest prize-giving speech that I've ever delivered. So that's good news. So welcome everyone to this momentous occasion, where we not only celebrate the achievements of our students, but we also mark a significant chapter in the history of Gore High School. And it is truly an honour to stand before you as we reflect on the past 115 years of this remarkable institution, which is about to embark on a new journey. Gore High School, since its inception in 1908, has been a bedrock of education, shaping the lives of thousands of individuals. Our school motto, "No reward without effort," has been more than just a phrase. It has become a guiding principle ingrained in the hearts and minds of our students, propelling them to success in such a huge range of achievements, both locally and globally. Tonight, we acknowledge not only the prize winners of 2023, but the countless students and dedicated members of staff who have not only contributed to the life of this school, but have also been profoundly shaped by it. It's a symbiotic relationship that has fostered growth, learning, and a sense of community that extends far beyond the school gates. We now stand at the crossroads of history, where Gore High School and Longford Intermediate merge into Maruawai College. I believe it is crucial to recognise that Maruawai is not a new school in the traditional sense. A new school starts from nothing. No pupils have ever gone to that school. No staff have ever taught there before. This amalgamation presents an opportunity to refresh and to redefine our educational vision for the future. Just as organisms adapt to their changing environment, organisations, including schools, must evolve to stay relevant. Our students, as part of Maruawai College, will carry forward a legacy dating back to 1908, taking pride in a history where effort leads to achievement, where high standards are upheld, and where we work diligently to build upon this legacy for the benefit of future generations. Many students will actually be following in the footsteps of their parents and their grandparents who went before them. For many of them, of course, they went to Longford Intermediate and then to Gore High School. So I see this not as the closing of one school and the opening of another. I see it as the bringing together of two schools into one unified entity. A heartfelt acknowledgement is due to the current board members for their tireless commitment to both Gore High School and the intricate planning necessary for Maruawai College. Their dedication, often facing bureaucratic challenges, has been commendable. To our wonderful staff and our senior leadership team, your skill, your enthusiasm, your commitment to our school and our students are truly appreciated. Thank you for fostering an environment that is filled with fun, laughter, industry and optimism, and thank you for your unwavering belief in the potential of our young people and the future prosperity of our school. Special thanks in order for those who are leaving us, and I'd like to take a moment to express our deep appreciation for their dedicated service. To Mrs. Watson, who after 36 years in the library and on our support staff is retiring. Her nurturing care and kindness is very much appreciated. Mrs. Hicks, with 35 years on the staff, is giving up her permanent role at the end of this year, but will continue to give her valuable service in a modified format next year. Her long-standing commitment is testament to her passion for young people and to fabric technology in particular. Ms. Hazlett, who for 7 years has shared her love and enthusiasm for drama and the performing arts, is answering the call for overseas travel. Her vibrant energy and creative spirit will be greatly missed. Mr. Simmons, who came to us 4 years ago from Whanganui via Kazakhstan, must have been something wrong with Google Maps that day, Ellen, and who so quickly established himself in the school teaching accounting and economics and nurturing football. Mr. Simmons is moving to Wellington to be closer to family. And Ms. Fairbairn, our sports coordinator, who's just been with us a short time, will be finishing up at the end of this year also. So to all of those people that I've mentioned, your contributions have been invaluable. You leave behind a lasting impact on our school, and as you move on to new adventures, please know that you take with you our gratitude and our best wishes. And now on a personal note, to our school community, to the students, to our staff, our board members and our parents, thank you for your unwavering support over the 12 years of my tenure as Rector. Your support has been the cornerstone of my work, and I couldn't have managed the challenges without you. There was no one more surprised than me to have emerged from 11 months of retirement to enter this phase, which my family jokingly call rehirement. I was most humbled by the welcome given to me by my return, by the students, by the staff and the parents, and by the faith shown in me by the board. I feel privileged to be here at this precise moment. The idea of joining Longford Intermediate with Gore High School has been around for decades, certainly well before my time. However, about 4 or 5 years ago, in the interests of advancing the future educational opportunities for our young people, I was moved to say to the board, I think the timing might be right. Why don't we ask the community if they want to join these two schools together? So I feel responsible in part for getting us to this point today. I'm genuinely optimistic about the future of Maruawai College, and I extend my best wishes to Mrs. Hamilton, the board members, the staff, and the students for the exciting journey that lies ahead. I'm sad too, of course. This place, as I knew it, it will change. My grandmother was a first-day pupil when Gore High School came into existence from the district high school back in October 1908. And here I am now, as Gore High School becomes Maruawai at the end of 2023. My thoughts go with you all as you collectively write this next chapter in the life of this beloved school. Thank you all and best wishes. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa.
Good evening, everyone. I now have the pleasure of reading out the prize lists for the year 9s and 10s and 11s. The explanation of the prizes are on the back of your prize-giving booklet. Names will be read in alphabetical order in groups, so I'll ask you to hold your applause until the last person in the group is presented. I'll also ask Mr. McKinley to present the year 9 and 10 and 11 prizes as well. Will the following students please come forward? Rehana Abdul Halim, Austin Aitken, Saffron Barrow, Hayden Brokoff, Cassandra Kallick, Gabby Kallick, Casey Campbell, Matthew Clinton, Clint Collins, Dylan Cross, Michaela Dory. Rehana Abdul Halim has a PTA Diligence Prize. Austin Aitken. Austin is first in 9H mathematics and has the Wright Cup Most Improved Boys Hockey Player. Austin Aitken. Saffron Barrow. Saffron is the most valuable girls, junior girls cricket player. Saffron Barrow. Hayden Brokoff. Hayden is first equal in year 9 technology food. Hayden Brokoff. Cassandra Kallick. Cassandra is first in 9E science. Gabby Kallick. Gabby is first in 9T health and physical education and has a prize for her contribution to girls basketball. Gabby Kallick. Casey Campbell. Casey is first in 9U health and physical education. She has the Nicol Cup for senior girls tennis and the Gaylene Ridley Trophy for the most for year 9 most promising netball player. Casey Campbell. Matthew Clinton. Matthew has academic excellence. He is 9U first in form overall, first in 9U English, first in 9U maths, first in 9U science, first in 9U social studies, first equal in year 9 technology food, first in year 9 digital technology, and has achieved the Junior Oratory Cup. Matthew Clinton. Clint Collins. Clint has achieved first in year 9 Te Reo Māori. Clint Collins. Dylan Cross. Dylan is first in 9E social studies. Dylan Cross. Michaela Dory. Michaela is first equal in year 9 art. Michaela Dory. Will the next group of students please come forward? Annika Duncan, Melanie Elliott, Jarvis Eden, Regan Gillan, Addison Grant, Riley Hadfield, Corey Holland, Wyatt Jameson, Brody Johnston, Sophie Mantell, Samuel Matheson, Charlotte McDowell, and Bella McKenzie. Annika Duncan. Annika has achieved the Learning Hub Prize for Academic Achievement. Annika Duncan. Ma- Melanie Elliott. Melanie has achieved the Bronwyn McBain Cup for Diligence and Application. Melanie Elliott. Jarvis Eden. Jarvis has achieved the most valuable junior boys cricket player. Jarvis Eden. Regan Gillan. Regan has achieved the PTA Diligence Prize. Addison Grant. Addison has achieved academic excellence. She is first equal in Year 9 Agriculture, first equal in Year 9 Art, and has the PTA Diligence Prize. Addison Grant. Riley Hadfield. Riley is first in Year 9 Music. Corey Holland. Corey is first in 9E Mathematics. Wyatt Jameson. Wyatt has achieved first in 9T Mathematics and has achieved the Lattie Cup for Junior Boys Swimming Champion. Wyatt Jameson. Brody Johnston. Brody has achieved academic excellence. He is first in form overall for 9E, first in 9E English, first in 9E physical health and physical education, and has achieved a contribution to Boys Basketball Award. Brody Johnston. Sophie Mantel. Sophie is first in 9W Social Studies and has the Gore High School Hockey Club's junior girl who best epitomizes no reward without effort. Sophie Mantel. Samuel Matheson. Samuel has achieved academic excellence. He is first equal in Year 9 Agriculture, first in Year 9 Design and Visual Communication, and has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Samuel Matheson. Charlotte McDowell. Charlotte has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Charlotte McDowell. Bella McKenzie. Bella has achieved first equal in Year 9 Performing Arts and has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Bella McKenzie. Will the following students please come up? Katiliri McKenzie, Mohammed Muktasid, Hosea Pasco, Charlie Pierce, Cooper Pettison, Chloe Robbins, Tara Rory, Charlie Springer, Alex Stevenson, Annalise Weir, Sophie Winkle, Nia Woodford, Ada Wernall, and Hayden Young. Tilleri McKenzie. Tilleri has achieved the PTA Diligence Prize and the Under 14 Girls Champion, the Odette Fitzsimmons Cup joint winner. Tilleri McKenzie. Mohammed Muktasid. Mohammed has achieved first in 90 English. Mohammed Muktasid. Hosea Pasco. Hosea has achieved PTA Diligence Prize, has the Under 14 Boys Athletics Champion, the Peter Anderson Cup, the GAA and HC Cup for Junior Boys Cross Country, and Under 14 Rugby Most Valuable Player, Hosea Pasco. Charlie Pierce. Charlie has achieved academic excellence. She is first in 9T overall. She has first in 9T social studies, first in Year 9 technology fabric, first in 9T science, and has the Under 14 Girls Champion Odette Fitzsimmons Cup joint winner. Charlie Pierce. Cooper Pettersson. Cooper is first in form overall for 9W, is first in 9W Maths, first in 9W Science, and first in 9W Health and Physical Education. Cooper Pettersson. Chloe Robbins. Chloe has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Chloe Robbins. Tara Rury. Tara has achieved first equal in Year 9 Technology Metal. Tara Rury. Charlie Springer. Charlie has achieved first equal in 9 Technology Metal and first equal in 9 Technology Wood. Charlie Springer. Alex Stevenson. Alex has the Greenfield Trophy, services to boys hockey, joint winner. Alex Stevenson. Annalise Weir. Annalise has achieved first equal in Year 9 Technology Foods, first in 9H English, first in 9H Science, and first in 9H Social Studies. Annalise Weir. Sophie Winkle. Sophie has achieved academic excellence. She's first in 9H overall, first in 9H physical, health and physical education. Sophie Winkle. Naya Woodford. Naya has achieved first equal in Year 9 Technology Wood and has a PTA Diligence Prize. Naya Woodford. Ava Wernell. Ava has achieved academic excellence. She is first overall in 9W, has first in 9W English, first equal in Year 9 Performing Arts. Ava Wernell. We now move on to the Year 10 prize list. Will the following students please come up? Sione Afu, Marlon Bennett, Quinn Campbell, Gemma Coleman, Cobain Fairclough, Tyrese Fittes, Johnny Gallog, Warren Green, Mary Hayward, Addison Knapp. Sione Afu. Sione has achieved the under 14 most improved rugby player and most promising player in under 14 rugby. Sione Afu. Marlon Bennett. Marlon has achieved first in 10K mathematics. Quinn Campbell. Quinn has achieved first in 10A physical health and physical education. Quinn Campbell. Gemma Coleman. Gemma has achieved academic excellence. She is first in 10K overall, first in 10K social studies, first in 10K health and physical education, first in year 10 technology metal. Gemma Coleman. Cobain Fairclough. Cobain has achieved first equal in Year 10 Technology Food. Cobain Fairclough. Tyrese is not with us tonight, but he has achieved the Year 10 Leadership in the Outdoors for all his hard work on camp. Johnny Gallog. Johnny has achieved academic excellence. He has first and equal in 10-0 English, first in 10-0 health and physical education, first in year 10 music. Johnny Gallog. Warren Green. Warren has achieved first in 10H physical health and physical education. Warren Green. Mary Haywood. Mary has achieved academic excellence. I'll start again. 10A first in form overall and has the Junior Instrumentalist Gore Town and Country Club Award. Mary Haywood. Alison Knapp. Alison has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Alison Knapp. Can the next group please come forward? Charlie Lawrence, Christopher McBrain, Holly McClelland, Alexis McDowell, Jessica Miller, Michaela Morrison, Libby Moylan, Rebecca Napier, Sophie Newby. Charlie Lawrence. Charlie has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Charlie Lawrence. Christopher McBain. Christopher has achieved first in 10A English, first in 10A Science, and first in 10A Social Studies. Christopher McBain. Holly McClelland. Holly has achieved Gore High School Hockey Club's Junior Player of the Year. Holly McClelland. Alexis McDowell. Alexis has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize, has the most promising player in the Junior A netball team, and has achieved the Under 15 Girls Athletics Hamilton Club, and is the joint winner. Alexis McDowell. Jessica Miller. Jessica has achieved academic excellence. She is first equal in 10K overall. She has first in 10K English, first in 10K science, first in year 10 agriculture, and first in year 10 design and visual communication. She has the Under 15 Girls Athletics Hamilton Cup and is the joint winner, and the BM Koenig Cup for junior girls cross country. Jessica Miller. Michaela Morrison. Michaela has achieved first in 10H English. Michaela Morrison. Libby Moylan. Libby has achieved first in year 10 drama and has achieved the drama trophy. Libby Moylan. Rebecca Napier. Rebecca has achieved academic excellence. She is first equal in 10-0 English, first in 10-0 science, first in year 10 digital technology. Rebecca Napier. Sophie Newby. Sophie has achieved the Hayley Morris Trophy for her contribution to netball. Sophie Newby. And that's the end of our group, so we'll give them a round of applause. Our next group is Clayton Naranga, Isabel Pollard, Ivy Solis, Francis Springer, Ava Tremaine, Hunter Wade, Zoe White, Riley Wilson, Adam Wing, and Yifei Yi. Clayton Naranga. Clayton is first in Year 10 Te Reo Māori. Clayton Naranga. Isabel Pollard. Isabel has achieved academic excellence. She is first in 10H overall, first in 10H mathematics, first in 10H science, first in 10H social studies, and first in Year 10 technology fabric. Isabel Pollard. Ivy Solis. Ivy is first equal in Year 10 technology food. Ivy Solis. Francis Springer. Francis has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize and has the John Clark Trophy for Most Improved Trap Shooter. Francis Springer. Ava Tremaine. Ava has achieved the PTA Diligence Prize. Ava Tremaine. Hunter Wade. Hunter has achieved the Most Improved Boys Basketball Player. Hunter Wade. Zoe White. Zoe has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Zoe White. Riley Wilson. Riley has achieved academic excellence. He is first in form overall for 10O, first equal in 10O English, first in 10O mathematics, first in 10O social studies, first in Year 10 technology wood, and has the under 15 boys athletics bowler cup. Riley Wilson. Adam Wing. Adam has achieved academic excellence. He is first in 10A mathematics. Adam Wing. Yifei Yi. Yifei has achieved first in Year 10 art. Yifei Yi. Congratulations to our Year 9s and 10s. We're now going to move on to the Year 11 prize list. Will the next group please come forward? Baton Benfield, Ella Brokoff, Taylor Buchanan, Tegan Cleaver, Layla Connerton, Samuel Copeland, Neve Cowley, Jacob Evans, Evan Fuller, Taylor Glover, Heidi Goatley. Baton Benfield. Baton has achieved the under 16 rugby most improved player. Baton Benfield. Ella Brokoff. Ella has achieved academic excellence. She is first equal in Year 11 agriculture, first equal in Year 11 culinary design, and has the joint winner of the Eastern Southland Home Science Alumni Trophy. Also, she is the most improved girls basketball player, Ella Brokoff. Taylor Buchanan. Taylor has achieved first in Year 11 design and visual communication and first in Year 11 technology fabric. Taylor Buchanan. is not here tonight. Tegan Cleaver. Tegan is first equal in Year 11 Agriculture. Tegan Cleaver. Layla Connaughton. Layla has achieved academic excellence. She is first in Year 11 Physical Education, first in Year 11 Geography, first in Year 11 Mathematics and Statistics, and is first equal in the Year 11 Culinary Design, and is joint winner of the Eastern Southland Home Science Alumni Trophy. Layla Connaughton. Samuel Copeland isn't with us tonight, but next we have up Neve Cowley. Neve is first equal in Year 11 History. Neve Cowley. Jacob Evans. Jacob has gained the 1911 Cup for the under 15 junior boys jumping cup and the under 16 rugby most valuable player, Jacob Evans. Evan Fuller.
Evan is first equal in Year 11 Mathematics with Algebra. Evan Bullocks. Taylor Glover. Has the PTA Diligence Prize, the Under 16 Girls Intermediate Athletics Champion, and the W. Wilson Cup for Intermediate Girls at 16 Cross Country. Heidi Goatley. The next group is Riffrey Gelder, Isaiah Brandt, Samara Holford, Mason Henderson, Charlie Hope, Nina Morton, George Hurley, Thomas Jones, Noah Kennedy.
Riffrey Gelder. Riffrey has the Under 16 Boys Athletics Cup, the McGibbon Cup, and Most Promising Boys Football Player, Riffrey Gelder. Keziah Grant. Keziah has achieved the Logan Cup Service to Girls Hockey and is Gore High School Hockey Club's most valuable senior girl player. Keziah Grant. Samara Halford. Samara has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Samara Halford. Macy Henderson. Macy is first in Year 11 Trades Academy Agriculture, first in Year 11 Technology Metal,
and has the Muscat Trophy for commitment and dedication to girls rugby. Macy Henderson.
Charlie is Gore High School Girls' first 11 hockey best and fairest player. Charlie Hope. Nina Horton. Nina has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Nina Horton. George Hurley. George is first in Year 11 Communications. George Hurley. Thomas Jones. Thomas has achieved the PTA Diligence Prize and has the Nathan Dixon Trophy for Community Service and is the joint winner. Thomas Jones. Raya Kennedy. Raya is first in Year 11 Technology Wood and first in Year 11 Drama. Raya Kennedy. Our final group for Year 11 are Philippa LaRue, Sophia Martin, Boston McLean, Caitlin Moss, Cynthia Mwangi, Hannah Sutton, and Eli Willits. Philippa LaRue has achieved the Gore Musical Theatre Prize. Philippa LaRue. Sophia Martin. Sophie is first in Year 11 Art. Sophia Martin. Boston McLean is not with us tonight, but he has the Nan and Five Ash Trophy for the Best Achiever Year 11 Rugby. Caitlin Moss. Caitlin has achieved a PTA Diligence Prize. Caitlin Moss. Cynthia Mwangi. Cynthia has achieved academic excellence. She has first in Year 11 Accounting. Cynthia Mwangi. Hannah Sutton. Hannah has achieved academic excellence. She's first in Year 11 Economics, first in Year 11 Science, first in Year 11 English, and first equal in Year 11 History. Hannah Sutton. Eli Willits. Eli is first in Year 11 Music. Eli Willits. That brings us to the end of the 9, 10 and 11 prizes. I would like now to introduce Gore High School's Kapa Haka group. And they will entertain us with Nei Rā Te Kaupapa and Wahini Toa.
Names again will be read in alphabetical order in groups. I will ask you to hold your applause until the last person in the group is presented. I ask the Rector, Mr. McKinley, to present these prizes. Will the following students please come forward? Chanel Asen, Ali Bedwell, Jaden Broom, Chloe Cockshall, Kira Dawson, Lucas Hadfield, and Lucy Harricks. Chanel Asen. Chanel is first in Year 12 Art and first in Year 12 Outdoor Recreation. Chanel Asen. Ali Bedwell. Ali received a PTA Diligence Prize. She also is the joint winner of the Dakin Leadership in the Outdoors Award and the Violet Lynch Trophy for Most Improved Senior Netball Player. Ali Bedwell. Jaden Broom. Jaden receives an award for contribution to Kapa Haka. He also receives the Citizens Trophy for Senior Boys Athletics, the Jenkins Cup for Senior Boys Field Events, where he's the joint winner, and the Matoura Licensing Trust Trophy for Player with the Most Points. Jaden Broom. Maybe not enough hands. Don't drop anything. Chloe Cockshall. Chloe was first in Year 12 Trades Academy, that's agriculture, and first in Year 12 Te Reo Māori. Chloe Cockshall.
Yeah, Chloe!
Kira Dawson. Kira receives the Baron Trophy for Dance. Kira Dawson. Lucas Hadfield. Lucas is first in Year 12 Mathematics with Algebra and Calculus, first in Year 12 Music, and he receives the Gore Town and Country Club Band Senior Instrumentalist Trophy. Lucas Hadfield. Lucy Harricks. Lucy receives an Academic Excellence Award. She is first in Year 12 Economics, first in Year 12 Accounting, first in Year 12 Geography, and first in Year 12 Chemistry. Lucy Harricks. The next group of students is Mac Heaps, Clark Jameson, Georgia Jones, Manmeet Kaur, Bishal Khatri, Jasmine Lama, Hannah Lawler, Ethan Mackay, and Nicole McBain. Mac Heaps. Mac is receiving the Quiet Achiever Award. Mac Heaps. Clark Jameson. Clark receives the Haggett Cup for Senior Boys Swimming. Clark Jameson. Georgia Jones. Georgia's not here tonight, but Georgia receives the WD Milne Trophy for Marksmanship. Manmeet Kaur. Manmeet is receiving the Braithwaite and Gray Award for Contribution to Performing Arts and was first in Year 12 Drama. Manmeet Kaur. Bishal Khatri. Bishal receives an Academic Excellence Award. He is first in Year 12 Mathematics with Statistics and first in Year 12 English.
Michelle Cartree. Jasmine Lama. Jasmine receives a PTA Diligence Award. Jasmine Lama. Hannah Lawler. Hannah is first in Year 13 Agribusiness and receives the Women's Institute Prize in Technology Fabric. Hannah Lawler. Ethan Mackay. Ethan receives a PTA Diligence Prize. Ethan Mackay. Nicole McBain. Nicole was first in Year 12 Tourism. Nicole McBain. Final group of Year 12s, Madison McDowell, Jesse McFadgen, Oliver McKenzie, Reese Miller, Tom Murray, Max Philpott, Jessica Udy, Benjamin Ewer, and Callum Wilson. Madison McDowell. Maddie is first in Year 12 Hospitality and the Service Industry. Madison McDowell. Jessie McFadgen. Jessie receives an Academic Excellence Award. She is first in Year 12 Agriculture, first in Year 12 Physics, and first equal in Year 12 Biology. Jessie McFadgen. Oliver McKenzie. Ollie receives the Fleming & Co. Cup for Senior Boys Cross Country. Oliver McKenzie. Reese Miller. Reese is first in Year 12 Gateway. Reese Miller. Tom Murray. Tom is first in Year 12 Technology Wood, and he is also the joint winner of the Dakin Leadership in the Outdoors Award. Tom Murray. Max Philpott. Max receives a PTA Diligence Award. Max Philpott. Jessica Udy. Jess receives an Academic Excellence Award and a PTA Diligence Award. Jessica Udy. Benjamin Ewer. Ben receives an Academic Excellence Award. He is first equal in Year 12 Biology, first equal in Year 12 History, and he receives the Gore High School Boys Football Player of the Season Award, trophy, something, award. Benjamin Ewer. Trophy, there we go. Callum Wilson. Callum is first in Year 12 Physical Education and first equal in Year 12 History. Callum Wilson. Right, now we move on to the Year 13 prizes. Can the following students please come forward? Angel Brown, Murphy Callahan, Sophie Cupid, Kayla Eckhout, Jessica Evans, Lewis Franks, and Meg Heaps. Angel Brown. Angel receives a PTA Diligence Award. Angel Brown. Murphy Callahan. Murphy is receiving the award for first in Year 13 Technology Metal. Murphy Callahan. Sophie Cupid. Sophie was first in Year 13 Photography and first in Year 13 Technology Fabric. Sophie Cupid. Kayla Eckhout. Kayla receives a Rotary Prize for Personal Integrity. She's first in Year 13 Tourism. Kayla Eckhout. Jessica Evans. Jess receives a PTA Diligence Prize and she is also the joint winner of the Nathan Dixon Trophy for Community Service. Jessica Evans. Lewis Franks. Lewis is first in Year 13 Art. Lewis Franks. Meg Heaps. Meg receives a PTA Diligence Prize and the Cup, I think, for Eastern Southland Netball Association Service to Netball. Meg Heaps. Right, the next group of students, we've got Gabrielle LaRue, Alyssa Little, Harry Lyle, Marshall McCleary, Natalia Mackay, Oakland Moody, and Mackenzie Napier. Right, Gabrielle LaRue. Elle receives an Academic Excellence Award. She is first in Year 13 Physical Education, first in Year 13 Chemistry, and receives the Anne Campbell Prize for first in Year 13 English. Gabrielle LaRue. Alyssa Little can't be with us tonight, but she is first in Year 13 Economics. Harry Lyle. Harry receives the Wanderers Cup for contribution to school football and Gore High School Football Best Team Player Award. Harry Lyle. Marshall McCleary. Marshall is first in Year 13 Mathematics with Statistics and he receives the McPhail Cup for Boys Singles Tennis Champion. Marshall McCleary. Natalia Mackay. Natalia is first in Year 13 Hospitality and Service Industry. Natalia Mackay. Oakland Moody. Oakland is first in Year 13 Accounting. Oakland Moody. And Mackenzie Napier. Mackenzie receives the Gillens Footwear Cup for Senior Girls Athletics and the Linda Beach Cup for Senior Girls Cross Country. Mackenzie Napier. Our final group of Year 13 students, we have Sarah Puller, Katie Soper, Nathaniel Ewer, Rubius Whangaparita Edwards, and Ailish Wilson. Sarah Puller. Sarah receives an Academic Excellence Award. She is first in Year 13 History, first in Year 13 Agriculture, first in Year 13 Biology, and she receives the Kay Hanna Prize for Senior Geography first in Year 13. Sarah Puller. Katie Soper. Katie receives the Gore Repertory Society Prize for Dramatic Work and the Thomas MacDonald Prize for First in Year 13 Drama. Katie Soper. Right, we've just got a few more prizes. Nathaniel Ewer. So Nate receives an Academic Excellence Award. He is first in Year 13 Mathematics with Calculus and receives the Edward Pickering Prize for first in Year 13 Physics. Nathaniel Ewer. So, a few more. So Ruby cannot be with us tonight, but Ruby receives the Gillian Cooper Trophy for contribution to school netball, and we still have Ailish Wilson. So Ailish is receiving the Bruce Smith Trophy for public speaking, the J.H. Grieve Prize for performance in music, and she is first in Year 13 music. Ailish Wilson. Right, now we will be entertained by our school band, Static Image, who will perform an original song called Monkey Bars. The band includes Bria Nicholson, Eli Willits, Briar Wilson and Taylor Phillips.
Sometimes friendships start out as something else. Sometimes we start out as enemies. I'll never forget the day I pulled you off the monkey bars for no other reason. Memories that we hold.
thanks to Bria, Eli, Briar and Taylor for their performance tonight. We now have the presentation of the memorial prizes, and I'd ask everyone to please stand for the presentation of these awards. I'll ask Mr. Jeremy McPhail to come forward and present this prize. It is the J.O. McPhail Memorial Prize for Agriculture. This year, the prize goes to Sarah Puller. I will now ask Bronwyn Reed to come forward and present the next prizes. The first prize is the Peter Reed Memorial Trophy for Excellence in Guitar, and it goes to Bria Nicholson. And the Peter Reed Memorial Trophy for Excellence in Craftsmanship in Woodwork goes to Matthew Christie. Please be seated.
We now come to the presentation of the Sportsperson of the Year Awards. Mrs. Christie will present these awards. Can the following students please come forward? Riley Wilson, Ellie Bidwell, and Clark Jameson. Riley is receiving the Everest Cup for Junior All-Round Sportsperson. Riley Wilson. Ellie is receiving the Kate Waite Special Prize for Best All-Round Girl, Ellie Bidwell. And Clark is receiving the Gore High School Best All-Round Sportsman Trophy, Clark Jameson. Mrs. Christie. We now reach the presentation of academic scholarships. I will ask Miss Olivia Grace on behalf of the Ex-Pupils Association to present these first awards. Would the following students please come forward? Nathaniel Ewer and Sophie Cupid. Nathaniel is receiving the JAC McCartney Memorial Scholarship. Sophie is receiving the Ex-Pupils Association Bursary for Excellence in and Out of the Classroom. Thank you, Ms. Grace. I will now ask Steve Kelly on behalf of Vet South to come forward and present this next award. The Vet South Year 12 Excellence Across the Sciences Award goes to Jessie McFadgen.
The next group will be awarded scholarship prizes, and I'm going to ask Mrs. Hamilton to present these. Will the following people please come up to the front? Angel Brown, Nathaniel Ewer, Ailish Wilson, Gabrielle LaRue, Harry Lyle, Marshall McCleary, Reese Miller, Mackenzie Napier, Sophie Cupid, and Mackenzie McLeod. Angel Brown is receiving the William Wallace Te Ihu Mania, the Academic Go-Getter Award. Angel Brown. Nathaniel Ewer. Nathaniel is receiving two scholarships, the University of Canterbury Hiranga Scholarship and the University of Canterbury Te Kākau a Māui Scholarship. Nathaniel Ewer. Ailish Wilson. Ailish is receiving the University of Otago Leaders for Tomorrow Entrance Scholarship. Ailish Wilson. Gabrielle LaRue. Gabrielle is receiving the University of Otago Leaders of Tomorrow Entrance Scholarship. Gabrielle LaRue. Harry Lyle. Harry is receiving the University of Otago Leaders of Tomorrow Entrance Scholarship. Harry Lyle. Marshall McCleary. Marshall is receiving the Otago Polytech Principals Leadership Scholarship. Marshall McCleary. We could do without that extra clap. Thanks. Where did I get to? Reese Miller. Reese is achieving the Prime Minister's Vocational Excellence Award. Reese Miller. Mackenzie Napier. Mackenzie is receiving the University of Otago Leaders of Tomorrow Entrance Scholarship. Mackenzie Napier. Sophie Cupid. Sophie is receiving the University of Otago 150th Scholarship. Sophie Cupid. Mackenzie McLeod. Mackenzie is receiving the University of Otago Māori Entrance Scholarship. Mackenzie McLeod. Well done to our scholarship winners. Now, this is the one of the moments we all wait for at the end of the year, and I'm actually going to ask Mrs. Hamilton to remain standing because she's going to have the pleasure of handing over the House Shield. It's always a hotly contested prize. It takes a year of gathering house points at all the House events and activities, and I'm pleased to announce the results of this year's competition. I will ask the House Captain of this House to come and accept the award on behalf of the winner, which is Cargill. Yeah! We now move to the presentation of the Foundation Scholarships. The Gore High School Foundation consists of past students of Gore High School who still have a strong interest and a connection to the life and values of the school. A scholarship from the Foundation comes with a financial sum at each year level, $100 at year 9, $200 at year 10, $300 at year 11, $400 at year 12, and $500 at year 13. And it also comes with a very special medal. I'd like to ask Miss Olivia Grace from Gore High School Foundation to present the first four of these Foundation Scholarships. This year, the Year 9 student who has consistently demonstrated our school value of courtesy goes to Samuel Matheson. This year, the Year 10 student who has best demonstrated effort goes to Gemma Coleman. This year, the Year 11 student who best honours commitment to extracurricular activities associated with the school is Jacob Evans. The Year 12 Foundation Award honours outstanding improvement, and this year it goes to Madison McDowell. Miss Grace, I just might get you to hand out this next one as well. Usually our Year 13 scholarship award is the Margaret Logan Gore High Foundation Scholarship, and Mrs. Margaret Solari can't be with us tonight. So the Year 13 scholarship goes to Mackenzie McLeod. Now we have our leadership awards, the Rector's Prize for Leadership. I'm actually going to ask Mrs. Hamilton to present these awards. The Rector's Prize for Deputy Head Boy is Nathaniel Ewer. The Rector's Prize for Deputy Head Girl goes to Gabrielle LaRue. The prize for head boy goes to Jack Murray. And for head girl, Ailish Wilson. I'll now hand over to Miss Hazlett. She's going to announce our Maruawai College prefects for 2024.
Good evening. It is an absolute privilege to announce the first ever prefects for Marawai College in 2024. As their dean for the past 4 years, I can wholeheartedly say that these students will be exceptional leaders for our school. These 11 students received a letter 2 weeks ago informing them that they had been successful in the prefect application and would be receiving a role tonight. They, like all of you, do not know which role they are receiving. So, without further ado, here are the prefect roles for 2024. The Environmental Prefect for 2024 is Max Philpott. Come on up, Max. Yep, come up. The Arts and Cultural Prefect for 2024 is Chanel Aysen. The Academic Prefect for 2024 is Ethan Mackay. The Community and Service Prefect for 2024 is Ben Ewer. The Junior Prefect for 2024 is Ali Bidwell. The Wellbeing Prefect for 2024 is Lucy Harricks. The Sports Prefect for 2024 is Callum Wilson. Deputy Head Boy for Marawai College in 2024 is Tom Murray. Can I just ask the previous head students to please vacate their chairs for the new head students? Deputy Head Girl for Marawai College in 2024 is Jessie McFadden. The first Head Boy for Marawai College in 2024 is Bashal Kutri. And the first head girl for Marawai College in 2024 is Mamet Kaur. Please join me in giving these wonderful students another round of applause. Thank you.
This year, our school Korowai Kākahu will be placed on the ducks. The Kākahu is the Kura school's symbol of honour and prestige. Today, a recognition of the pinnacle of our motto, Parma non sine pulvera. I will ask Mr. McKinley to come forward and present these prizes.
Right, so we've had some pretty big prizes and some new head prefects and new prefects, and now we come to the pinnacle of the prize giving, where we announce our proxime assessant and our ducks, so our top academic scholar and our next top academic scholar. This year the proxime assessant is a joint award. It goes to Sarah Puller and Nathaniel Ewer. And I'll ask Mrs. Adrian Rogers to present the Ducks Award. So if she would come forward and present the E.C. Smith Bursary and Ducks Award, please. To Gabrielle LaRue. That concludes our presentations for tonight. I'd like to thank our talented students
and staff for their input into tonight's ceremony. Sarah Puller, Static Image and the Wall Pile Kappa Group for their entertainment, and our very own math teacher, Fairburn, for playing the bagpipes.
Thanks to Peter Power
for doing the sound tonight.
And Matthew Clinton for live streaming Kappa to families all over the world.
I ask all prize winners to please stay behind immediately after the ceremony for a photograph with Miss Hazlitt. And you should know who you are, so you should know if you're in one of those groups that need a photograph, please stay behind. Kia pai to wā whakata, kia noho haumaru. Have a good holiday, stay safe, and we look forward to seeing you all in the new year.
Our head students, guests and staff off the stage.
day when you would get up out of here. So, long time friends, we remain the same until you return one day. I will say, I'm still thinking of when we used to chill and reason till the morning sun. So we talk of places never seen before. Who would think you'd be the one to go out there, over mountains, ocean.